Hi guys, I promised you the third part by now of my collection video is gonna happen really soon, and it's happening now. So I will talk today about DC and Vertigo stuff that I own, and let's just kick it off. So you probably know a little bit of this stuff by now because I've showed it the last time I talked about Marvel, which is around here. And those are my DC books. And I will start with the DC Universe first, which I just recently got into. I mean, I have to say, most of the stuff that's on the shelves here, I haven't read. Why? Because I'm liking superheroes, but not as much as other stuff, especially Vertigo. But I will talk about Vertigo in a minute. Let me just show you my DC superhero books. This is one of the rare ones that I read because it's by Grant Morrison and I loved it. Also Superman. It's still wrapped here. I read it in single issues back when it came out. I have here another two absolute editions. One is Hush by Loeb and Lee, and the other one is The Long Halloween by Loeb and Sale. Both of them unread. So I know they are classical Batman tales, but I just haven't read them yet. Out of those here, I probably already read Year One, but it's a long time ago, The Killing Joke and Arkham Asylum. All of them pretty good, not definitely as mind-bending as some other people claim them to be, but I guess it's all also like a matter of taste. I'm liking Batman, but it's just not my superhero. He's not my favorite. I didn't grow up on him. I grew up on Marvel Comics, so when I came to Batman, I was a bit too aware of all the tropes and all the things that come with superheroes. So I couldn't enjoy him as much as other people could. Gotham Central is a DC Universe book, but it could be a Vertigo book. It's about a police precinct where they deal with superhero crime, or just, you know, basically crime happening in a superhero universe. And it's written by Brubaker and Rucka and drawn by Michael Lark. So you know it's quality. And I read it in single issues, but not all of it. Probably like 15 or 20 issues of it. I remember to like them very much. Now I have the Omnibus, which looks like this. It's a thick one. It's, I think, 40 plus issues. And yeah, I haven't gotten to it, but I will, because this is something that I'm really eager to read or reread. Some more stuff here, some more Batman hardcovers. Black Mirror I read by Snyder, Scott Snyder. This will get me a few downvotes, but I didn't really enjoy it. I think I totally enjoyed the Francesco Francavilla art on it, which is amazing. But the writing of Scott Snyder is just not my favorite writing. It's a bit too, how should I put it? It's not pretentious, it's just a bit too, I can see it coming. I can see the beats coming, you know. It has a rhythm to it, which is a bit too obvious. Yeah, I can't tell you more about that. I would need to do maybe a special video on that, why his writing doesn't work for me. Here we have the Starman Omnibus. The whole run, I paid a pretty penny for it, and I'm happy to own it. I read the first volume and half of the second, and I thought it was fantastic. It's by James Robinson. It's written by James Robinson. Drawn by Tony Harris. Tony Harris, you probably know from, didn't he do Walking Dead? I'm not sure. Maybe I'm talking bullshit now. I don't know. But he's a great artist. I'm pretty sure he did the book with Brian K. Vaughan, Ex Machina, right? So it's really well drawn, but it's the writing is what really stands out. It's really cool. Crisis on Infinite Earths, well, this is like a legendary crossover event which DC had in the 80s, where they basically cleaned up their whole continuity. And I think it's an event book. It's really not easy to digest a few decades later, but I will get to it someday, because so much is referencing to it. So yeah, I should probably read it. Multiversity by Morrison, which frankly I haven't finished yet. I was expecting it to blow me away, and some issues did and others didn't. I have to say, Grant Morrison, always a treat, but not always, you know. I enjoy that he's doing stuff differently, but that doesn't mean that I really, really love everything that he does. Watchmen, nothing to say about Watchmen. You know everything about it by now. And I have the deluxe edition here, which is pretty nice. I'm always thinking about, you know, getting the absolute, but then I think, why should I do it? I haven't opened the deluxe in years, but I'm happy that my girlfriend read it in deluxe. I read it in paperback form and it was still great, so who bothers? The Orion Omnibus by Walter Simonson, haven't read it yet. But, you know, I enjoyed Simonson's Tor, and those are characters created by Jack Kirby, so it can't be that bad. The New Frontier by Darwin Cook, who recently passed away, great artist, great looking book. The story, I haven't read it yet. Again, I sampled it, I thought it's neat, but I didn't commit to it yet. Here are some Superman books. I will show you this because it's pretty cool. It's called Superman Cover to Cover, and it's just great Superman covers through the years and through the different eras, and like really, really campy and fun ones, more iconic statuesque ones, you know, this kind of variety that such an old character brings with him. And also some information, and it's really cool. Oh, this one I really have. I have in its original printing. Yeah, that's really cool. I think you can grab it for cheap. And it's maybe a better history book about Superman and Action Comics than all those Superman biographies and such. Well, what do we have here? Yeah, the Alan Moore book, which is obviously great. I read it, it's really cool. Secret Origin by Jones. Oh, I forgot that I have this. I have to read it because I have still to enjoy anything by Geoff Johns. Another downvote is happening now. I know DC people love him, and I think I can get to this place to understand why, but I haven't gotten to the place to join the euphoria. So yeah, some more Superman books, a few more Batman books. The Wonder Woman Omnibus by George Perez, and the Earth One Origin Story by Grant Morrison. I have made a video where I talked about this. And, well, of course, what should be highlighted is this is like a super, super old edition. And I like that it's super old. I read Batman The Dark Knight Returns in German. And I remember I was a kid, and I was pretty much blown away by it. It was so, so good. So if I have any connection to DC or Batman, it's Frank Miller's version, which is more a mature take on the whole thing, and it's less superheroic. And yeah, this is probably still I haven't reread it yet in the past few years, so I maybe I should do it just to see how it holds up. But this is something which will always stay with me. It's such a iconic, even the cover, you know, it's such an iconic portrait of Batman, and it's what basically made up the image of Batman in the Christopher Nolan films. So let's continue with more classical superhero stuff. I have Green Lantern by Geoff Johns, volume 1 and 3. I pre-ordered 3 and got it, and you know, I couldn't. Again, I tried to get into Geoff Johns' writing, and I have to say Green Lantern, I enjoyed quite a bit, but not enough that I finished the Omnibus. I think I stopped, you can see it here, it's like 1/5 in. JSA, it's probably also 1/5 or maybe 1/4, a little bit better, but again, a bit too, I don't want to, you know, because I know he has his fans, and I just don't get it. Maybe let's stay with that. It's okay. Seven Soldiers of Victory. I read some of those in single issues. It's the hardcovers. Grant Morrison's kind of a, it's a world building project within the DC universe. He did like a big event with different miniseries featuring different characters, not very well known ones, and it was all interconnected, and it was decent. I don't think it was fantastic. I wanted to read it in one piece, but I don't know if this will ever happen. Those 75 year celebration books of characters, I have it for Lois Lane and I have it for The Flash. And I read some Flash material, and it was nice, it was fun. So I got this, Grant Morrison's and Mark Millar's take on The Flash, and I haven't read it yet, again. Here we come to stuff that I actually read. Manhunter, I read in single issues and have restarted again to read it in trades, so I think by now I've read something like 70% or 3/4 of it, and it's really cool. And I've always looking for stuff by Mark Andreyko, but until now I was disappointed with his other writing. But his Manhunter was really, really a highlight in NDC's publishing history of the recent, you know, one or two decades. If you haven't checked it out, you can get it for cheap. You should try it. It's really a cool female character before female characters were like the norm like today. And she's not a very likable person. She's a very controversial character. And this, especially being female, was a new thing back then. Props for doing it. It's a really good book. Mike Grell's Green Arrow. I read the miniseries Longbow Hunters, also I think the first three paperbacks, and they're very enjoyable. Especially the miniseries and the first volume are fantastic, but also the follow-up stuff is really good. It's some of the best superhero stuff that I read in the past years, and I think the 80s were a high point for DC Comics. I mean, obviously The Dark Knight Returns and Watchmen, but also a lot of more mainstream stuff like Green Arrow or Suicide Squad by John Ostrander, this is early 90s, but still The Spectre, also by Ostrander. They had a lot of weird far out stuff. They tried a lot of new stuff, which Hear the Question Again by Dennis O'Neill. I haven't read it yet, but it's again like an offbeat concept. Some of this stuff, some of this vibe, emerged into Vertigo Comics, which we'll talk about in a minute. Here is some New 52 stuff. Not much to say about it. Some stuff I liked, some stuff I didn't or didn't care. The stuff that you see here, obviously, is stuff that I was interested in. Wonder Woman, Earth 2 by Robinson. Really, the Wonder Woman run by Azzarello and Chang is fantastic. You should check it out. It's really, really good stuff. This really got me interested into Wonder Woman in the first place. Batman and Robin by Tomasi and Gleason, which is nice. It's fun. Grant Morrison's Action Comics. Haven't read it yet. Dial H for Hero. Animal Man. Frankenstein Agent of Shade. So stuff that I sampled or haven't read yet. Can't talk too much about it. Hitman. I've read the first two trades. Big, big fun stuff. It's Garth Ennis at his funniest, I think. Because he does play, the whole superhero thing. But not really. You know that he doesn't like superheroes if you have read The Boys. So it's really cool. This is some Wildstorm stuff, which I enjoyed. The really ugly Supreme books, which by Checker Publishing. It's Alan Moore, yes. But can you take Alan Moore if it looks like this? It's like the worst kind of, Image Comics at its absolute worst. I don't know if I can put myself through it, really. It's just so ugly. I'm sorry to say that. Some more books here. Nothing especially exciting down there. The Spectre I always wanted to check because of the controversy. I don't know if you know about it. The writer was filing suit against the Comics Journal because they called him demented or something crazy or something to put such weird stuff on paper. And he took it seriously and he filed a suit against them. And since I enjoyed the Spectre in his new iteration by Ostrander, I wanted to check out the historical one. This is also nice. Kinetic by Kelley, Pucket and Warren Please. It's a fun little story. It's a DC line. I don't remember what DC Focus it was, I think. They started in the beginning of the 90s where everything was about, let's try a new universe. And it was a more like, again, a realist take on having superheroes or superpowers. And this is one of the nice efforts which came out of it. Okay, enough with DC Universe. Let's get to Vertigo, which is, as you can see here, just as much as the DC Universe stuff, but of the Vertigo stuff, I read a lot more. So, we have Sandman here, we have the Absolute Editions 1 to 4, which comprise the whole run of Sandman, and which I read, I think, 2/3 of it, or even more. I think it's... I always wanted to do a reread of the whole run, but I have to say, I have a hard time getting through the first 10 issues or so. They're very different from what Sandman becomes later on, but it's still one of the high marks probably of the DC publishing history. But it's like talking about Watchmen. Everyone knows about Sandman. Let's just go on. Absolute Ronin, which is really, really cool. I want to show it to you. I don't see this often. Oops, shown. And, this is what Absolute Editions were made for. Because the art in this oversized edition is so beautiful. It's by Frank Miller, colored by his later to become wife, or already wife by then, I don't know. Lynn Varney, is it correct? Well, have to check on that. Varley, yes. So yeah, it's really, really beautiful stuff. I haven't finished it yet, but it's a great book. You should. This is like a book which I can recommend in oversized editions. The Ice Zombie Omnibus. I've read a few issues and they were fun. And it's run by Mark Allred, so yeah, it's probably cool. So let's get to Hellblazer. I have the first Hellblazer volume in this old edition, and then I started buying the new ones. I am now by... I have reached volume 5, and I know that I probably read 5 and 6 and 7, the whole Ennis run. Oh, and 8. I read in single issues back then, so I will probably reread it because it's such a long time ago, but it's really good. It's a consistently entertaining and well-written horror book, which I can recommend. Some more Constantine books, you know, other older editions of it. A Milligan one. I know Milligan and Hellblazer, it's a controversial thing. A lot of people don't, a lot of Hellblazer fans don't like Milligan's writing. I enjoyed it, it's fun. We have Northlanders here, by, Mr. Wood, Brian Wood, and David Gianfelice. It's fun, it's cool. It's one of Brian Wood's better books, I have to say. I'm not the biggest fan, but it's pretty good. Unknown Soldier. Oh, I forgot to buy the... This is really weird because I actually read the first two volumes and really liked them. One of my favorite authors, Joshua Dysart, wrote those. Alberto Ponticelli drawn it, and it's a really good book. It's a war book, which the setting is an African nation, which is torn by war, and it's about the horrors of war, not necessarily in Africa alone, but it's dealing with child soldiers and such, so there is some stuff specific to those conflicts over there, and it's well written, and it's also a political book, which I think is a rare thing and should happen more often. Why the Last Man? I don't know where I stopped when reading the single issues. I always wanted to finish it, but, well, never did. Lucifer, I read the first three volumes. I think this is heading for deluxe soon, I'm pretty sure. So if you haven't bought it yet, I would wait for another half a year or so, because... I'm pretty sure that we do that they will do deluxe editions, especially with the TV series and such. And it's a really good book. If you're into Sandman, this is the closest that you will get after Sandman ended. Some say it's even better than Sandman. I would love to compare, but this I read a few years ago. I started reading it, and Sandman is like over 20 years ago, so it's hard to compare. But I reread Sandman Mystery Theater, who I had in single issues, and it's so good. It's so good that I will do a special video about it when Volume 2 comes out. It's such a great noir series by Matt Wagner. Probably his best work. He's using different artists for every arc, but well, I'm talking about it, but I want to talk about it in a video of itself. So, yeah, Planetary Omnibus by Warren Ellis. Warren Ellis, I'm a big fan of Warren's high concept sci-fi stuff, and this is one of his finest works. It's also like, I think if I would I would put a list together and recommend 10 books, this would be on it. It's just something you should have read. It's so easy to like it. You know, some stuff is a bit more special, like Grant Morrison's Doom Patrol, which I have here. I have it in Omnibus, but really, I'm kind of sad that I gave away my paperbacks. I had like the first four, and I really loved them, so I was thinking, cool, I will upgrade to the Omnibus. But since then, I really don't want to take it out of the shelf, because look at it. It's a monster of 1,500 pages. This is the problem with Omnibus. I've talked about it before. It's just not doable, not readable, basically. Animal Man by Grant Morrison, which is fun. I've read the first 10 issues, stopped then, and I think I should continue because I think the end is where it's at. This is a phase, like, again, of DC Comics where they introduce all those crazy concepts. And this is one of the series which became Vertigo and which made Grant Morrison well known in the States. And after Animal Man and Doom Patrol, he could do basically everything. So he did Invisibles, which is a crazy ride. Can't sum it up here in a few words. It's just too weird. The Filth, I haven't read it. We Three, it's a fantastic book. No one talks about it. I think it would make a great movie. It's about sentient animals. And the art is amazing by Frank Whiteley. So if you don't own it, you should buy it in oversized hardcover. This is another book that I can recommend in a deluxe edition because it's beautiful. Flex Metallo, haven't read it yet. Kid Eternity, really nice, very unknown book by Grant Morrison. And undeservingly so, because Duncan Figueredo's art earns the oversized edition. And Grant Morrison's writing is a bit more concise here. It's not super far out. And I enjoyed it very much. Sculpt, I've only read 1.5 volumes, but I thought they were excellent. I think this is still Jason Aaron's best work, or at least my favorite work of his. And it just shows how high quality Vertigo was. Sweet Tooth, I've read the first volume. I wanted to enjoy it more than I did. I still bought the second, but it's still an open here. But I really, really like those DC Deluxe books. I think they're great. Here we have Swamp Thing by Alan Moore and John Todleben, which I'm ashamed to say also stopped reading, being in the second volume. I think, you know, if I get a basic idea of a series, I get a little bit bored with it. Not that I don't think it's not worth reading, but if I get the essence of it, I'm like, okay, cool. It's a great series. I want to have it complete, but I don't need to read it, which is kind of stupid. But yeah, this is how I work. Here is some more Swamp Thing, and then Peter Milligan stuff. I really loved Peter Milligan. You know that because I did a video on him. So I won't talk about his comics here. Just check out the Peter Milligan video that I did. Here are some more Vertigo books. Preacher, which I really liked. Of course, not finished. Testament, which is very unknown. Douglas Rushkoff. It's really cool. It's basically trying to mix the mythical and the Christian Bible tale with a futuristic sci-fi approach. And I think it's working quite well. I don't know why nobody talks about it. I thought it was quite well done. This is also a book that I really enjoyed, by Sis Spencer and Dean Ostrom, Buddies. It's a weird little sci-fi story. High concept, of course, because it's Vertigo. And if you just want to read a nice miniseries, this is one I can really recommend. More stuff. Punk Rock Jesus, you know it. There is an oversized deluxe edition. And again, Sean Murphy's art deserves it. So if you buy it, you should give it a try in an oversized format. It's also a nice story, which, well, is a reinterpretation of the Jesus, the New Testament story of Jesus upcoming. So I thought it was a success. Not all people agree with me. Some think he should stay with the drawing and not write himself. I thought it was nice. Madame Xanadu, haven't read it yet, by Matt Wagner. And, well, I guess that's it. Because this stuff is already indie stuff that I will show to you in my next video. I hope you enjoyed it. There is so much more to say, obviously, especially about Vertigo stuff. But I think some of it I will just feature in own little videos in the future. So there is a last part featuring those books here, which will come up in the next days. Until then, thanks for watching and bye-bye.